Good guys, back to another vlog, and today I'm with John John and Hoverboard, and my hoverboard got the scoots. One right there, it's mine. But yeah, we're gonna do scooter clips, so yeah. Okay, guys, hope you enjoyed those clips. Now we're gonna go inside and introduce myself. Then we're gonna go to the store. So, sorry for that cutout, but yeah, here's a little poor sport over here because he doesn't want to see their snake, but he could be a poor sport, I don't care. So, let's go now. Okay, guys, here he is. He's in the thing right now. We go up here. See? Right there. Hi, buddy. He's an albino snow white corn snake. So let me get him out for you. Hey, guys. I got my albino snow white corn snake. He is a little sketchy, but John John's going to hold him now because he wants to be in this. He's literally under his water dish. It's funny.
You guys can tell that he's kind of pinkish.
Because he's a baby.
He's just a baby, but when he gets older, all his lights are... Oh!
Bruh. Some music on for you guys. There's some music for you.
Since I was young, they never had the dedication.
Okay, guys, those are some dancing clips and snake clips. So yeah, why are you watching Toy Story? That's like so old and young. We're not gonna watch it right now though. Cause that movie sucks. I like that part when he says, "You're not gonna turn me into mashed potato." So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the vlog.
Snake really says thank you.
Yeah, he says thanks for all this. He said thanks for the 100 sub support. So yeah. So, we'll see you next clip when we're at Circle K. Guys, if you haven't already, go subscribe to my channel. All you have to type in is Josh School Days. And yeah, this right there is all my videos. Freaking Brendan, all kinds of stuff.
Guys, back with another video.
I don't like my voice when I do that. Why am I on GTA? I don't know why that's on, but GTA. But, yeah, you can go subscribe. And yeah, so let's talk to Brendan. Or not. Why am I on Musical.ly? I'm stupid. Here's my editing apps. This is what I use, Action Directory. All of my videos, but yeah, so fuck. Go here with John, but let's watch this, guys. This looks dope.
Hi, I'm Conan O'Brien, and like many celebrities, I have too much time on my hands.
What's up, guys? Everything Apple Pro here. Have you guys ever wondered how many screen protectors would it take to completely bulletproof your iPhone? So we're just going to see if we can actually stop a bullet in glass laminate with basic screen protectors, glass ones, of course, that you can buy anywhere. So we've got 20 right here, 40 right here, and 60 on this. Now, I don't promise your iPhone's going to be easy to use after putting these on.
Yo, hello? I can't hear you. Hold up a sec. No, I just got my screen replaced. What do you mean I can't buy stuff from China? It's cheap,
but it certainly might be bulletproof. Which one would you rather have? So we're going to be using an AR-15 for this. For the first shot, it is a smaller bullet. Like,
by the way, guys, AR-15 sucks, so it probably will stop
this. But if we have to, we would be using a pistol as well. Certainly a larger caliber, but a slower velocity. All right, so I'm very curious to see. This is a question I've been wondering myself for a very long time, and I finally have the ability to test it. So yeah, let's see if we can make our iPhones bulletproof at home with a simple kit of 60, 40, or 20 screen protectors. All right, so first things first, the 20 screen protector layer, not very thick, but certainly, you know, it looks like a little bit of extra protection at least. See if we can stop an AR-15 bullet from at least cracking the display. I'm very curious to see what's gonna happen right here. All right, 20 screen protector test. AR-15 locked and loaded in 3, 2, 1.
Now, if you're watching this, or if, like, this guy is dumb as shit, that's not even an AR-15. Like, that's a fucking rifle.
That does not stop anything. Damn.
Alright, so 20 screen protectors certainly did not do the trick. Went clean through, and then some through the phone. Wow. Okay, so, I don't know if 40 will be any better. Glass doesn't really make a good bullet-resistant material. Alright, so let's move on to the 40 then. Alright, so 40 layers deep. Let's see if this does any different at preventing bullets from entering that internal structure. In 3, 2, 1. Well,
holy crap.
Definitely no.
Whole phone crack in half.
Alright, so apparently 40 didn't do any better. Absolutely blew through all of them into the iPhone and out the rear.
Guys,
with,
do you see that? Like,
wow.
The other
crazy
one?
Carnage. So, guys, into the iPhone.
Watch.
Alright, so.
Right here, guys. Watch. Sorry about this brush. Okay. Right there, guys. It made. It like went right through the Apple logo. That's actually pretty dope. But yeah. How am I gonna post it? Get this now. Well, that sucks, huh? Hold on. Hold on. I know what to do. Take the brush off. And then, yeah. Now, there we go.
Apparently, 40 didn't do any better. Absolutely blew through all of. Apparently, 40 didn't do any better. Absolutely. Alright, so apparently, 40 didn't do any better.
What? Absolutely blew through all. Same thing.
Apparently, 40 didn't do any better. Screen protectors, this isn't cheap, but will it be bulletproof? Alright, in 3, 2, 1.
Oh.
So as it turns out, 60 screen protectors does not make your iPhone bulletproof. It seemed to almost get worse.
Okay guys, that was the video. Hope you enjoyed. Comment, subscribe, and I'll see you next.